There's a universe of science waiting to be discovered on the moon. Each discovery unlocks new knowledge, inspiring a generation of scientists and engineers. It's a stepping stone to Mars, a breeding ground for new technologies, and a catalyst for a brighter tomorrow. Landing a spacecraft on another world is the first big step, and it's never easy. Advanced cooling technologies has supported landers and rovers operating in extreme environments and has developed specialized heat pipes and heat rejection systems to do so. Decades have gone by since the Apollo landing. Now, we will once again reach the moon's surface with the next lander, delivering dozens of payloads, including ACT thermal technologies. This opens a new chapter of sustained lunar exploration. To establish any lasting foothold for humanity on other worlds, abundant power will be essential beyond what solar can provide. Since 2015, advanced cooling technologies has been a part of the Planetary Nuclear Power Project, partnering with NASA to develop nuclear fission reactors optimized for space. ACT specialized components like high-temperature heat pipes that operate over 800 degrees Celsius, fluid loops, and cold end heat rejection systems enable these compact reactors to operate safely under extreme conditions. Modular nuclear power, backed by ACT thermal technology, isn't just vital for potential moon and Mars bases. It may one day power human voyages to destinations deeper in the solar system. When it was realized ice was captured at the South Pole of the Moon, it opened endless possibilities for sustainable life and rocket fuel for future missions. It was imperative to develop strategies to map and mine this ice over time. The first mission, in 2024, NASA's Artemis Lunar Rover, known as the Volatiles Investigating Polar Exploration Rover, or VIPER for short, in which ACT provided the entire thermal control system. One of the biggest challenges was to survive the lunar night, a 14-day period of freezing cold temperatures near that of liquid nitrogen. Let's explore how ACT was able to meet this challenge. One of the prevailing strategies to survive the lunar night is to create a warm box for cold-sensitive components in the center of the rover. The warm box is then insulated, and the encapsulated components are connected to an exterior radiator panel via ACT's technology. The first technology is a loop heat pipe with a thermal control valve. It's able to transfer large amounts of heat during the lunar daytime with its high thermal conductivity and effectively shut down during the lunar night by reducing its thermal conductance via the thermal control valve. A second technology that can be employed to survive the lunar night are variable conductance heat pipes. These are passively controlled. A non-condensable gas blocks off the heat pipe from being able to transfer out heat during the lunar nighttime, keeping the heat contained in the warm box. Lastly, ACT designed a variable conductance switch called a thermal switch. The switch makes contact during the daytime, allowing the conductance path between the component and the radiator panels to be operational. When the cold of lunar night hits, the switch retracts and prevents heat from escaping the warm box. Communication between the Earth and the Moon will be critical, and so novel technologies are needed to facilitate the deployment of satellites. ACT has recently developed the process of additively manufacturing loop heat pipes, resulting in a rapid design and manufacturing process compared to other machining methods. This reduces the cost and enables more satellites to be deployed, creating a reliable constellation for communication. ACT's advanced thermal control systems and continued innovation allow us to explore the moon and unlock its secrets. These technologies are paving the way for a sustainable future in space, where humans and machines can work together to unravel the mysteries of our universe and beyond.